Good morning, children. So in previous class you learned about the what is meant by cell. So how the cell is important for our living beings, not only for plants, animals and everything. Cell plays a prominent role in our lives to do several functions in our body. So you learned about the who discovered the cell, nothing but Robert Hooke. And I also demonstrated in the previous video about the different types of experiments to observe the cells in the different types of organisms like plants and animals. Okay, today we are going to learn about different types of cells, nothing but plant cells and animal cells. Plant and animal cells. So all cells are same? No, when comparing to the plant and animal, the cells are different. How can you differentiate the plant cell and animal cell? So first, if you take the plant cell, plant cell is rectangular in shape and it is covered by another layer. So the outer layer of the plant cell is called cell wall, and the outer to the cell wall and another membrane in the sense like a wall, like how our room was protected by a wall, like that the cell also protected by wall. But extra wall will be present in the plant when comparing to the animal, that is called cell wall. And another membrane present next to the cell wall, that is called cell membrane. Another membrane which present next to the cell wall, that is called cell membrane. So when you compare with animal cell, so plant cell is rectangular in shape, but animal cell is circular in shape. And when comparing to the membranes which encloses the cell particles, it is having an extra wall, plant having extra wall called cell wall. But coming to animal cell, it is not having any extra wall, cell wall, but it is having only a membrane which protects the cell, that is called cell membrane. Okay, here plant cell is having extra cell wall and animal cell is not having extra cell wall. Okay, so this is the differences in the so these are the differences between the plant and animal cell, one of the difference. And cell wall is made up of a protein structure called cellulose. Cell wall is made up of cellulose. And what about the cell membrane? How the cell membrane acts in both animal and plant cell? Cell membrane acts as a semi-permeable membrane. Cell membrane acts as a semi-permeable membrane. Name itself, semi-permeable, means whatever the particles required for the cell function, that particles only will be allowed through the cell membrane, and the remaining particles will not be allowed through the cell membrane, so that it is called semi-permeable membrane. Okay, it is a one thing. And next, cell wall consisting of different types of plastids. Cell wall consisting of different types of plastids. It is not required in your 8th class, but somewhat information will be passed from 8th class to the 9th class. So in detail I'm not telling, but basically you have to learn what are the things present in the plant cell and animal cell. Okay, so types of plastids are present in the animal cell. Plastids are absent. Okay, so in animal cell plastids are present, in plant cell plastids are absent. So what is the need of the plastids? So here in plant cell plastids are present, in animal cell plastids are absent. So what is the requirement, what is the need of plastids in the plant cell? Plastids helps in the photosynthesis process. Plastids helps in the photosynthesis process. What is meant by photosynthesis? Photosynthesis nothing but the plants which prepare their own food, that is by the process called photosynthesis. Animal required any food preparation by their own? No, they depends upon other organisms, like they depends on plants and they depends on other animals. They need not to prepare any food, so that they won't require plastids. But plants has to prepare their own food by the process called photosynthesis. So what are the cell organelles involved in the process of photosynthesis? Are nothing but plastids. That's why plastids are absent in animal cell. And you can see a balloon like structures in the plant cell. But here the structure, balloon like structures are absent, or maybe in a small in size. That is one of the difference of plant cell and animal cell. What are these balloon like structures? These are called vacuoles. So in plant cell we can observe bigger sized vacuoles. In animal cell we cannot find vacuoles, or we can find very small sized vacuoles. So what are the this is about the vacuoles. And nucleus was present towards left side, or sorry, nucleus was present towards sides, but when comparing to the animal cell, nucleus was present towards center. Okay, in plant cell nucleus was present aside, but in the animal cell nucleus was present towards center. Why this difference is there? Means because of presence of vacuoles. Sometimes they'll ask the question, why in plant cells nucleus was present at a side when comparing to the animal cell? Because presence of bigger vacuoles. These are the main differences we can find between the plant cell and animal cell. Okay, so next we are going to learn about the discovery of nucleus. Who discovered nucleus and what is the importance of nucleus?
Let us observe now clearly about the differences between the plant cell and animal cell. So the differences, main differences between and similarities between the plant cell and animal cell, now we are going to discuss. First, cell wall was not present in animal cell, but it is present in plant cell. See, extra wall is present, a green color structure, that is called cell wall. It is made up of cellulose. That is first difference. Second, shape of the animal cell, it was circular shape, and plant cell was rectangular in shape. Third, vacuole. In animal cell we can see smaller than vacuoles than the plants. In plant cells we can see bigger vacuoles. So the plant cell was filled with 90% of vacuoles. In animal cell, small vacuoles are present. fourth centrioles. These centrioles are present in lower plants. In animal cells, centrioles are present. Chloroplast. In animal cells, chloroplast absent. Plant cell, chloroplast was present, which helps in the process of photosynthesis by preparing its own food. Sixth one, nucleus. Plastid. So plastids are absent in animal cell. In plant cell, plastids are present. In that, plastid is a double membrane organelle found in the cell of plants and algae that contain chlorophyll and carry out photosynthesis. Plants prepare its own food and stores in the form of starch. Seventh one, plasma membrane. In your animal cell, cell membrane was present. In plant cell, cell membrane along with the cell wall will be present. Eighth one, presence of lysosomes. In plant cells, in the animal cells, they carry a prominent role. Cell wall was absent in animal cell. Cell wall is present in plant cell. Ninth one, cilia. Hair-like projections are called cilia. In animal cell, in most of the plant cells, they do not contain cilia. In animal cells, they are having cilia. Now, similarities. It consisting of cytoplasm, ribosomes, mitochondria, rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, animal, both in animal cell and plant cell. They're having same kind of cell organelles. So here you can look after the comparison chart so that you can learn easily animal cell and plant cell. Cell wall is absent, present shape round or irregular. So in this rectangular, vacuoles are small or absent in animal cell. In plant cell, they are large. Next, centrioles. Centrioles are present in animal cell, present in lower plants. Chloroplast absent in animal cell and present in plant cell. Plastids are absent in animal cell, present in plant cell. Plasma membrane was present in animal cell, present in plant cell. Lysosomes, they are occur in chloroplast, they are not evident in plant cell. And cilia, they are present in animal cell, absent in plant cell. These are the comparison chart that you can easily learn. Similarities are like having mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, and these are the similarities. So this is plant cell and animal cell.
Now we are going to discuss who discovered nucleus. So nucleus, this is the word we discussed before in the plant cell and animal cell. So it acts as a, it plays a prominent role in the cell. So it is called brain of the cell. Nucleus is called brain of the cell. So when we, if we are not having brain of our, if you have any damage in the brain, any work was performed by our body? No, we cannot perform any work by our body. Why? Because brain is a control of our body. Like that, brain also, brain, like a brain, nucleus acts as a brain in the cell, which controls the all the activities of the cell. So who discovered cell? Nucleus. Nucleus was discovered by Robert Brown. Nucleus was discovered by Robert Brown in 1831. He is a botanist in the sense who works on plants. Okay, he is a botanist and he observed orchids. In orchids, while he observing the orchids, on the upper layer of the upper layer of the cell in the sense epidermis. So upper layer of the cell is called epidermis. In that particular layer, he found a massive substances that he named it as a nucleus. Okay, who discovered nucleus? Robert Brown in 1831. He is a botanist who, while he observing orchids, he observed on the upper layer called epidermis, a massive layer was formed that is called nucleus. Nucleus plays a prominent role in the all the cell activities. So it is called brain of the cell. A nucleus consisting of a genetic material. Nucleus consisting of genetic material like DNA. Nucleus consisting of a genetic material called DNA. DNA abbreviation deoxyribonucleic acid. What is meant by DNA? Deoxyribonucleic acid. So this DNA was present in where? In the nucleus, in the form of a genetic material. So what is the role of DNA? Genetic material means which passes from one generation to the another generation through the process called heredity. You may look like your grandmother, you may talk like your grandfather. So all this inheritance was carried through this genetic material which is present in the nucleus. Okay, so this is what about the discovery of nucleus. Next we are going to learn, observe the cells in the leaf.
Now we are going to observe and or perform the activity to observe the cells in the dicot stem. In this, what we observed and what we learned from this activity, we'll see now. First, take a small portion of the plant stem. Cut the thin cross section of the stem with the help of a razor or blade. Now take a watch glass with water and place across the section of the stem in it. While handling the glassware, please careful. Next, transfer the thin section of the stem from the watch glass on the permanent slide with the help of a brush. Next, cover the slide with a cover slip and place it under the microscope. Observe the slide under the microscope. So, what is the observation? It is observed that the cells have different shapes and structures. Four different types of tissues are observed from the microscope. What we learn from that? From the experiment, we learn that the cross-section of the stem consists of 4 groups. Group A cells from the outermost layer of the stem, and they provide definite shape and protection to the stem. Group B cells occupy the major portion of the stem. These groups of the cells have special organs that help in carrying out the process of photosynthesis. Group C cells join together to form long structures that can help in carrying food and water to the entire plant body. Group D cells are present at the center of the young stem, and they form a hollow structure in case of mature stem. Thus, different shapes of cells performing different functions are observed in a single organism.
Next, we are going to learn about the diversity of the cells. Diversity means difference. So different cells based upon the number, size and shape. So based upon the number, size and shape. First we discuss about the number of the cells. If an organism having a single cell, they are called unicellular organisms. Several times they asked in 1 marks. So the organisms which are having single cell, they are called unicellular organisms. And what more than single cell, the organisms which are having more than single cell, they are called multicellular organisms. Okay, the organisms which are having more than single cell, they are called multicellular organisms. So what are the examples of unicellular organisms? Amoeba, paramecium, euglena. Okay, these are the examples of unicellular organisms. Next, multicellular organisms, human beings. We comes under multicellular organisms, animals like dogs, cats, and plants. Plants are also multicellular organisms. Okay, this is about the number present in the animals, number of cells present in the animals. So if animal has consisting of single cell, they are called unicellular organisms. If an animal consisting of more than single cell, they are called multicellular organisms. So what are the functions performed by, is there any differences between the multicellular and unicellular? Only one difference is there, that is having single cell and multicellular. But the functions what the human beings or animals or plants are doing, some life process like respiration, digestion and coordination, everything, the life process, whatever the life process is doing the multicellular organisms, same that life process is done by the unicellular organism with having single cell. Okay, so same functions will be performed by the unicellular when comparing to the multicellular organisms. Okay, so the size may be different from multicellular to the unicellular. In detail, we learn about the diversity of the cells.
Now we are going to learn diversity of the cells. Variety in cell number, shape and size. In this module, you will learn that organism shows variety in cell number, shape and size. You can see variety of animals from small to the big. So perform all the life process like respiration, digestion. So everything life process will be done like other animals. So the cells of different organisms vary in terms of number, shape and size. If you see amoeba in human being, amoeba is having single cell means amoeba made up of single cell. Human being is made up of millions of cells. But organisms that are made up of only one cell are called unicellular organisms. Amoeba is an example. And our unicellular organisms perform all the important life process using only one cell. Example of unicellular organisms: amoeba, paramecium, euglena. And organisms that are made up of more than one cell are called multicellular organisms. A multicellular organism has a specialized organ system to perform different life processes. Examples of multicellular organisms like dog, cat. So, if you take human being, he is having different types of cells based upon the structure and size, like nerve cells. Each cell was covered by cell membrane. The shape fat cell is circular, rarely spherical, and muscular cells that are spindle shaped structure pointed at each end of this cell. These are called muscle cells. And one cells are other cells like branched cells, they are called nerve cells. So the cells, when compared from one cell to the another cell, they may be vary in size. They may be very small, micrometers, and some are very long, which connects the body from one region to the another region. The size of the cell has no relation with the organism in which it is present. Let's recap. The cells of organism vary in number, shape and size. The organisms that have only one cell are called unicellular organisms. The organisms that are made of many cells are called multicellular organisms. Cells are found in different shapes. These include round and spherical, long and pointed. The size of cells vary from few micrometers to few centimeters.
Now we are going to learn about the types of blood cells. We are having three types of blood cells: RBC, WBC and platelets. Okay, three types of blood cells. RBC in the sense red blood cells. WBC, white blood cells. Okay, so RBC, they are red in color. RBC are red in color. WBC, no color. WBC, no color. Because of presence of red color in the RBC, they are called erythrocytes. Cytes means cells. Erythro, red. Okay, so RBC are also called it as erythrocytes. Erythro means red, cytes means cell. What is meant by WBC? WBC is called leukocytes. WBC are called leukocytes. Leuko means white or colorless. Cytes means cell. Okay. So, what is the shape of the RBC? They are spherical in shape. RBC are spherical in shape. WBC, they are having no shape. RBC are spherical in shape, WBC are no shape. And RBC, the life 120 days. The life of RBC was 120 days. WBC was less than RBC. The life of WBC was less than RBC. And what is the role of platelets? Platelets helps in clotting of blood. Platelets are helps in the clotting of blood. So when you got injury, after 3 to 5 minutes, the blood will, whenever the you got injury, the blood will come out. Yes. So after 3 to 4 minutes or 5 minutes, the blood will stops. Who will stops the blood? Means the platelets which are present in our blood will clots the blood. In detail, in further classes, you'll learn. Okay. So WBC is differentiated into two types: granulocytes and agranulocytes. Okay, so WBC are differentiated into two types: granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes are again differentiated into three types, like basophils, neutrophils, eosinophils. So in textbook they are given clearly, once observe. So granulocytes, actually WBC is differentiated into two types: granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes is again differentiated into three types: basophils, neutrophils and eosinophils. Neutrophils acts as a policeman to our body. Neutrophil acts as a policeman to our body, like an army. So how the army protects our country? They won't allow any foreigners or any which cause damage to our country. Yes, like that, the neutrophil also acts as like an army people, which stops the foreign particles which damage our body and fight against to them. They are called neutrophils. Granulocytes is differentiated into two types. They are monocytes and lymphocytes. Okay. Agranulocytes are differentiated into monocytes and lymphocytes. This is the types of blood cells. Types of blood cells are differentiated into three types: RBC, WBC and platelets. RBC is also means red blood cells. WBC means white blood cells. RBC is red in color. White bloods are no color. And because of red color present in the RBC, they are called erythrocytes. Erythro means red, cytes means cell. Leukocytes are called white, leuko means white or colorless, cytes means cell. And the shape of the RBC was spherical and RBC was no shape. So the lifetime of RBC was 120 days. RBC, WBC was less than 120 days. And RBC was differentiated into two types: granulocytes and agranulocytes. Granulocytes is differentiated into three types: basophils, neutrophils and eosinophils. Neutrophils acts as a policeman to our body, which protects against foreign particles which damage to our body. And agranulocytes like monocytes and lymphocytes. Platelets, these are the other particles of blood cells which helps in the clotting of blood when we got injury. Okay. So this is the types of